ethnic consultant for the youth, and there are so many problems with the cops or any other because of the lack of knowledge of the culture. So do you have any idea or any commitment?
Sure. Look, I'm surprised, actually, that you're saying there are not many counselors or consultants through our school system, for example, and employment, because that's not my understanding. I have, for the last number of years, worked with the school boards on this very issue. We have a special group of in fact, I have referred a number of individuals to that consultation council, who are from ethnic communities, to help bridge and to provide advice.
Not enough.
And so, you know, if there are not enough, then certainly I'm the first one to say, let's make sure that we get the appropriate number of people engaged in our community that will help to raise awareness and that will help to bridge whatever gaps are there. I can tell you that another area that we have to address within York Region specifically deals with our senior citizens who are not very versed in the English language, who have come here, who are citizens of our province, who are elderly, and they are not capable of communicating very effectively in the English language, but they are, for example, in our long-term care homes, in nursing homes, in retirement residences. And the older a person gets, the more difficult it is to ask the right questions or to understand what is going on. I believe that we have to make a concerted effort, especially in our hospitals and in our long-term care facilities, to have people who understand and can communicate in the mother tongue. And whether that is Farsi or whether it is other languages, this is an obligation that we have. And, you know, we have made a commitment, as I mentioned earlier, that a PC government will invest an additional $6.1 billion in the first 4 years into our healthcare system. And part of that investment should be going into areas like this, especially long-term care, and not just building the spaces, but making sure that the level of care is there, that it's quality care, and being able to communicate with people is one of those fundamental services that we have to provide.
What is your message to the Iranian-Canadian community?
My message to the Iranian-Canadian community is really the same as it is to every other community in the province. We are in challenging times. Our province has had 8 years of what I believe is mismanagement. We have doubled our debt in 8 years to $246 billion. This year alone, the McGuinty Liberals will spend $16 billion more than they take in. That goes on top of the debt. We have the highest taxes ever. People are having a difficult time paying their energy bills, their home heating bills. People are frustrated in terms of how much they pay for taxes and how little they're getting. It's time for change. My message to the Iranian community here in Ontario, in York Region, is that there is hope. That by electing a PC candidate in their riding, by electing a PC government, they will be guaranteed, first of all, that we will remove the HST from their hydro bills and their home heating bills. We will remove the debt retirement charge from their hydro bills. We will reduce their taxes by 5%, their income tax on the first $75,000. We will provide income splitting so that husbands and wives can actually split their incomes and reduce the overall tax burden. We will ensure that people in this province can end up once again actually paying the bills, keep more of their hard-earned money. We will assure them that health care will be protected. As I mentioned before, we will invest in health care and ensure that the gaps that exist there are closed. that they have the best health care on this planet. We're going to invest additional $2 billion in education to ensure that their children get the highest quality education that they expected when they came to this province. Finally, we will ensure that their tax dollars are treated with respect. We will provide accountability and transparency. Everything that the government does in terms of contracts will be posted on a government website so that people see where that money has gone. There will be no more $1 billion wasted in health under the e-health boondoggle. Those days are over. And so we ask people to take the time to consider for all of the additional billions of dollars that they have paid in taxes for the last 8 years, what have they got for it? I believe that when people take the time to think very carefully about what the options are, they will conclude that they want responsible, accountable government, and a Tim Hudak PC government will provide them with that.
Mr. Kilis, thank you so much for the time. Thanks from your staff for managing this.